Dr. Janine Krause, and today I'm going to talk about how your digestive system is key to your overall health. If your digestive system isn't functioning properly, the rest of you is not going to function properly. Why? Because your whole digestive system is really integral for mood. It's your second brain. It's also really key for your immune system. And so if your digestive system's trashed, your immune system's going to be trashed. And so the healthier digestive system, the healthier immune system. The healthier digestive system, the healthier the mood may be. And so, nevertheless, one of the big things that I like to talk about first is the red lights, looking at warning lights. Is there anything going on in your digestive system that's not exactly the way you want it to be? Gas, bloating, burping, constipation, diarrhea. Those are all huge warning lights that something's not right in the digestive system. You should be pooping at least once a day, maybe twice or three times. That's great. How many of you out there look at your poop? Yep, I said poop. You gotta look at it. It's your body's gift to you every single day, hopefully, to tell you what's up. Do you see food in there? Do you see little kernels? Do you see pieces of lettuce? Those are warning signs. And so let's talk a little bit about the digestive system. We start digesting when we think about food. We should be creating some saliva. If you don't have saliva coming out, you've got a dry mouth, that's indicator number one. You are not going to be breaking down your foods efficiently. Then think about, are you chewing? Average American chews about 7 times than swallows. That's not enough time to be able to break down food. We have teeth. We should use them. 25 chews per bite. That at least gives us a little bit of time. Some folks even go out to 50. I gotta be honest, I can't do it. I've tried. But 25, that's doable. I would definitely say working yourself up to that. The more you chew, the more you spend time focusing on your food and not multitasking while you're trying to eat, the better off your digestive system is going to be. Now here's the next thing. Are you taking any proton pump inhibitors, Nexium, things like that? Medications that are going to block the acid in your stomach. If you're blocking acid in the stomach, you're blocking your ability to be able to process, break down foods efficiently. And so those are big things to consider in the scope of things. So if you have reflux, that's usually why folks will be taking an acid blocker. If you have reflux, there might be another reason why you have that reflux. It might not be that you need to block the acid. It might be that you're eating too many tomatoes, peppers, potatoes, onions, garlic, spicy stuff, too much caffeine. Those kind of foods open up that sphincter between the esophagus and the stomach, allowing things to shoot up through there, which would cause reflux. And so it's just something to think about in the overall scheme of your digestive system. As we move down, as things go into your small intestine, you might not be producing enough of the digestive enzymes you need to break down your food once it gets into the small intestine. And so if you don't break down those foods sit on the intestine lining. And what do? They ferment. That's the making pizza in your belly, as I call that, or making bread in your belly. You start to bloat. Why? Because those little molecules sit there, and then you need all that bacteria to start to work to break down those molecules. And as that's happening, you get bloated and bloated and more bloated. And so digestive enzymes are key, especially if you're over 30 years of age. You do reduce those as you get older. And so as things move down into your large intestine, that's where we're working on all of the reabsorption of water, things of that nature. That's where all the bulk of your beneficial bacteria live, in that large intestine. If you don't have a great amount of good bacteria in there, well, you might get more bloating and you might feel cramps. You might feel upset in your stomach. And so those are key components of your digestive system. Now, let's step back for 1 second. The small intestine, that is your area where you absorb the most of your nutrients. If those cells aren't properly stuck together and we've got separation between those cells on your digestive system lining, things get across in your bloodstream. Gluten. It's touted as being such a problem because we have this idea that a lot of people are gluten sensitive or that folks have gluten allergies. Well, it could be that those cells just separated apart, that gluten got across into the bloodstream, and now we're having an attack on that gluten that shouldn't be in the bloodstream. What does that lead to? Well, an attack on other things in your bloodstream. And so perhaps as those cells separate apart, you might get other pieces of things crossed, like say mango or pineapple or string beans. Those little molecules get across and now the body's attacking those. What does that lead to? Different aches and pains in certain joints and muscles. And then this overall sense of fatigue. Why? Because your body's not getting the nutrition where it needs to be in those cells. And we're also not getting that healing of the muscular tissue because the body's way busy trying to figure out all of those immune reactions happening in the bloodstream. So your digestive system is very, very important. And there are some red lights to look for. Gas, bloating, diarrhea, constipation, stomach aches, reflux. All of those are warning lights. Something to pay attention to in terms of determining your owner's manual. Why? Because there are foods that are good for some people and not so much for others. It depends on your genetics. It depends on what type of bacteria you have in your gut. And it also depends on certain lifestyle factors and if you're able to tolerate certain medications that you might have to be on. So nevertheless, it's really important to pay attention to your digestive system. And I will be posting certain things on how to check in on your digestive system, in addition to certain checklists and resources so that you can be accountable and check on your digestive system and make sure that it's running as efficiently as possible. I'm Dr. Janine Krause, and this is a little blurb on the digestive system. Thanks for watching.